Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
So I think there is a lot of opportunities within the Aditya Birla Group for any finance guys, which we have seen, and there's a long history around it with the finance people growing within the group. Hi guys, welcome to Conversations Cafe Online. Today we've got someone very unique. Often because we are focusing on MBAs, we don't talk so much to people from other professions, other kind of education. But somewhere a lot of people from different kinds of education converge for a variety of roles in a variety of businesses. Once you are done with your formal education, things don't just go in a very straightforward line. So, we are talking to someone who is a chartered accountant, a very tough course. Krishna, welcome to Conversations Cafe Online. Really excited to have you here.
Thanks, Kunj.
Krishna, to begin with, when people do their higher education in finance, Krishna, they typically want to get into banks or any other financial institutions. We don't hear a lot of people getting into general management companies like Aditya Birla Group. So how come you picked that path, and what has that been like for you as a finance professional?
Aditya Birla Group provides a lot of opportunities to the finance professionals. There is a long history of finance professionals growing within the group. And given the variety of the opportunities which the group can provide in terms of the businesses and the roles that a chartered accountant or a finance guy can do within the group.
What are some of the different roles that you've had? And because of the wide variety of companies it has, it also means that you've had to juggle with all kinds of industrial companies and consumer facing companies. So what has that been like?
So I was part of finance leadership program of Aditya Birla Group, and we had four different stints in the year one, where I got exposure into four different businesses. One was Aditya Birla Money, then Ultratech Cement, Pulp and Fiber, and Hindalco. And I got exposure into four different functions in those four different stints, and got exposure to interact with the CFOs and senior leaders and kind of, you know, get the understanding of the business, as well as the focus was to deliver as much as you can in those 3 months stints. And year two, I went to Hindalco in a plant role. Post that, I moved to BRC, which is a corporate function, and then I'm right now into the CFI head office, which is a chemical sector of the group.
You enter Hindalco after your first year, and for the first time you are put on top of things, and like, you know, there are so many things to handle. So take me through that early time at Hindalco.
So after the year one, I got offer into the Hindalco Renukoot plant, which is a manufacturing setup. It's a 4 lakh ton aluminum manufacturing plant, and it's an integrated manufacturing setup. So right from bauxite to aluminum, and then further fabrication and rolling. There's a term called internal financial control, which was kind of a new term which was coming in at that point of time. And people and the plants were kind of getting used to, you know, the compliance part of it. So you had to look into multiple processes and how whether the controls are there or not. So you could get into those processes with the support from your colleagues and your superiors. So my second role was in a corporate function, which is in BRC cell, we call it, which is the senior most function of the group, which supports the chairman department in finalizing the planning and budgeting process of the next year, overview of the businesses on a quarterly basis, and approving the large capexes of the group. So we call it CREC committee, and our boss used to head it, and we used to support him with our analysis and recommendations. So best part of this role was that it was not about a report writing or, you know, you study and then you summarize it and just give it. But we need to give a clear view or recommendation from a professional point of view, that whether we should go ahead with that as if you are a CEO or as if it was your business and you had to do it. So from that point of view, each and every initiative that we used to do in that role every day used to have an impact on the businesses that we were handling.
Krishna, ABG sits on a lot of consumer facing apparel businesses. Okay, on the bottom of it, the backdrop is basically grasses. Is that correct?
In ABG, we have exposure into a number of B2C businesses as well. At the same time, we have a lot of B2B businesses, which is manufacturing. So Grasim includes, one is pulp and fiber business, which is one big chunk. Cement is a subsidiary. And then chemicals is one. So chemicals is, we call it chemicals, fertilizer and insulator sector, which covers the chemicals part of it. So it is mainly B2B business that we do, but we are venturing into B2C businesses also.
People talk a lot about MIS, and MIS is a big influence on how decisions are made by people at all the levels in an organization. Can you tell us a little bit more what that role is about and what do you do at Grasim?
I head a department of MIS for CFI sector, which is chemicals, fertilizers and insulators. So it is comprising of 9 different businesses. Within those smaller SBUs that we have within the sector, on a timely basis, right, whether it is market, whether it is our performance, and from that point of view, relevant decisions can be made. So one part of it is more regular, with more reporting kind of, which includes regular reporting, monthly reporting kind of things, which is more of performance related. And another is that you keep a tab of market, how the market intelligence that is going on. So you keep a tab of it, how analysts are viewing you, how performance of other competition is happening. That is another part of it. Then we have a lot of activities related to strategy, like ad hoc works that, I mean, ad hoc activities, initiatives that may come.
Tell me that most memorable one moment that you had when you were like, I'm really proud of the company that I work for and the kind of work I get to do here.
I think the most memorable moment, I would count, one of them would be that getting nominated for the Chairman's Award and meeting him personally in the award. So I got nominated twice for 2 consecutive years in Aditya Birla Awards in Emerging Professional category. So I think that is one of the most memorable moments.
Where next? What are some of the things within ABG that excite you? What are some of the things that you want to take up going forward?
My plan is, which also comes from the training that we get and the exposure which we get, is that you need to have a set of skill sets to reach at the CXO's level. So, can be for a CFO, it can be accounts as a base level, accounts, MIS, planning, then banking, treasury, and then maybe risk management and investor relations in between. So few of the checkbox which has been ticked in my career, and few of them which are related to risk management or banking treasury, which are yet to be ticked, or say commercial, which probably I'll look for in the opportunities that might come within the group.
We wish you luck on your journey to CFO at ABG. Really appreciate you taking our time and speaking to us.
Cheers. Thanks, Kunz.